Cherubim and seraphim falling down before thee, God everlasting through eternity.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
My brothers and sisters, let us acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. Have mercy on us, O Lord.
For we have sinned against you.
Show us, O Lord, your mercy.
And grant us your salvation.
May Almighty God have mercy on us. Forgive us our sins and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Let us pray. Attend to the pleas of your people with heavenly care, O Lord, we pray, that they may see what must be done, and gain strength to do what they have seen. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the first book of Samuel. Hannah arose after a meal at Shiloh and presented herself before the Lord at the time Eli the priest was sitting on a chair near the doorpost of the Lord's temple. In her bitterness, she prayed to the Lord, weeping copiously, and she made a vow, promising, O Lord of hosts, if you look with pity on my misery of your handmaid, if you remember me and do not forget me, if you give your handmaid a male child, I will give him to the Lord for as long as he lives. Neither wine nor liquor shall he drink, and no razor shall ever touch his head. As she remained at prayer before the Lord, Eli watched her mouth, for Hannah was praying silently, though her lips were moving. Her voice could not be heard. Eli, thinking her drunk, said to her, How long will you make a drunken show of yourself? Sober up from your wine. It isn't that, my lord, Anna answered. I am an unhappy woman. I have had neither wine nor liquor. I am only pouring out my troubles to the Lord. Do not think your handmaid a ne'er-do-well. My prayer has been prompted by my deep sorrow and misery. Eli said, Go in peace, and may the God of Israel grant you what you have asked of him. She replied, Think kindly of your maidservant, and left. She went to her quarters, ate and drank with her husband, and no longer appeared downcast. Early the next morning, they worshiped before the Lord and then returned to their home in Ramah. When Elkanah had relations with his wife Hannah, the Lord remembered her. She conceived and at the end of her term bore a son, whom she called Samuel, since she had asked the Lord for him. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
My heart exalts in the Lord my Savior.
My heart exalts in the Lord my Savior.
My heart exalts in the Lord. My horn is exalted in my God. I have swallowed up my enemies. I rejoice in my victory.
My heart exalts in the Lord my God.
The bows of the mighty are broken, while the tottering gird on strength. The well-fed hire themselves out for bread, while the hungry batten on spoil. The barren wife bears seven sons, while the mother of many languishes.
My heart exalts in the Lord my Savior.
The Lord puts to death and gives life. He casts down to the netherworld, he raises up again. The Lord makes poor and makes rich. He humbles, he also exalts.
My heart exalts in the Lord, my Savior.
He raises the needy from the dust. From the dunghill he lifts up the poor to seat them with nobles and make a glorious throne their heritage. My heart exalts in the Lord, my Savior.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Mark. Jesus came to Capernaum with his followers, and on the Sabbath he entered the synagogue and taught. The people were astonished at his teaching, for he taught them as one having authority and not as the scribes. In their synagogue was a man with an unclean spirit. He cried out, "What have you to do with us, Jesus of Nazareth? Have you come to destroy us? I know who you are, the Holy One of God." Jesus rebuked him and said, "Quiet, come out of him." The unclean spirit convulsed him and with a loud cry came out of him. All were amazed and asked one another, "What is this? A new teaching with authority? He commands even the unclean spirits and they obey him." His fame spread everywhere throughout the whole region of Galilee. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
As we begin these weekdays of ordinary time, we see in the gospel readings Jesus continuing now after his baptism to go out into the world and to make the presence of God known. And in particular today, he starts teaching in the synagogue. And the people that are listening to him are wondering what is different about him. Why is he so convincing? And basically, he's teaching with authority, and it means simply he's teaching with God's help what he needs to do to fulfill his Father's will here on earth. And then we see him performing a miracle of an unclean spirit coming out of a man. Again, the people question, why is he doing this? Who is he? Does he think he's the Son of God? I think as we look at the way that Jesus taught, the people that he interacted with, and most importantly, the people who observed him, we see that Jesus is very single-minded in the good sense that he is here to fulfill his Father's will. And no matter who is around, who needs help, he's going to reach out to them and do something for them, whether he's going to cure them, whether he's going to teach the people there with a new teaching and teaching with authority, whatever it might be. I think for us too, God is always present in our lives. And so consequently, we need to take that presence of God, live with it, nurture it through our prayer, through the reception of the sacraments, and then most importantly, to spread that word just as Jesus did. May this Eucharist give us the grace to speak with authority on matters spiritual relating to God. Let us pray. For our Holy Father and all the bishops, may the Lord bless and protect them as they proclaim God's truth to the world. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all people throughout the world who have yet to hear and receive the good news of Christ, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
those who struggle with pain, may God bring them comfort and assure them of his love. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all of us gathered here, may God help us persevere in prayer as Hannah did. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all who have died, may they soon be welcomed into God's everlasting kingdom of peace and joy. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Gracious and all-powerful God, hear and answer our prayers on behalf of a hurting and wounded world. We make these prayers through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the bread we offer you, fruit of the earth and work of human hands. It will become for us the bread of life.
Blessed be God forever.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the wine we offer you, fruit of the vine and work of human hands. It will become our spiritual drink.
Blessed be God forever.
Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands, to the praise and glory of his name, for our good and for the cause of his holy church.
May your people's oblation, O Lord, find favor with you, we pray, that it may restore us to holiness, and obtain what they devoutly entreat, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Father most holy, through your beloved Son, Jesus Christ, your Word through whom you made all things, whom you sent as our Savior and Redeemer, incarnate by the Holy Spirit and born of the Virgin, fulfilling your will and gaining for you a holy people, he stretched out his hands as he endured his passion, so as to break the bonds of death and manifest the resurrection. And so with all the angels and saints we declare your glory, as with one voice we acclaim. Holy, 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 Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis our Pope and Daniel our Bishop and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer to each other the sign of peace. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. With you, O Lord, is the fountain of life. In your light we see light.
At this time, we invite you to join in a spiritual communion. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you were already here, and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen.
Let us pray. Humbly we ask, Almighty God, be graciously pleased to grant that those you renew with your sacraments may also serve with lives pleasing to you, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go in peace.
Thanks be to God.
Saint Michael,
we are angel, defend us in battle. We are protection.